Hey, what's up? This is St. Joe, SoundsandGear.com, and today we're checking out Arturia SparkLE. It's the new mini version, I guess you can call it, or scaled down version of the Spark hybrid drum machine. So this is the controller that goes with the software, and I've been obsessed with this thing ever since I saw it at NAMM. So Arturia sent me one over to check out for review, show you guys what's going on. So I'm definitely interested. As you can see, this form factor is really cool. It feels really solid. Knobs, pads, everything feels good, and it even comes with its own little sexy case to stick it in. So really travels well, but for me, I just like the layout. I like how much space it takes up, and I've been playing with this thing since I got it. Really fun. I came up on drum machines. I had drum machines before I even had any type of samplers or anything like that, so I didn't even have to open the manual to figure out how to use it. It's just really intuitive to get in and start making beats and messing with grooves and stuff like that. So I'm gonna show you the interface and then kind of show you how the hardware works in terms of sequencing and stuff like that. So let's check it out. All right, so here's the SparkLE interface, really pretty much laid out exactly like the hardware. So you got your transport area, your tempo, your shuffle, you got your performance area inside here as well. You got your different parameters. You can actually change these because these are assigned to the individual, whichever pad you're on. So you can actually change what you are actually controlling for each individual sound. So that's pretty cool. You got your data wheel right there to choose your instruments, kits, all that stuff. Your looper, you can turn that on. It actually kind of slices up your pattern. You got all your pattern buttons and your pattern banks, the first four, A, B, C, D. You can go into each bank and each one has 16 patterns. So of course you got 1 through 8 for your pads. If you press this button here, now you got 9 through 16. Mute, solo, select. You got a few different secondary functions like save, redo, undo, metronome that show up on the controller. And there are different areas inside of here, like your metronome is up here and you can turn the volume there, stuff like that. So really pretty much laid out exactly like this. You don't have an accent knob or button on your controller, but you have one inside of the software. And you don't have a shuffle on the controller, but you have one in the software. You don't have a tap tempo anywhere, which is something that I think is sorely missing in this. Anyway, go to the bottom. That's where you control all your sounds. You can see you got your different sounds set up. You can go in and tweak each one. This is a sample-based sound, so it's got 6 layers. You can go in and change the reverse or the start endpoint of those samples, but you can't really like change everything for each layer. Like some of this stuff applies to the whole pad, you know, like your decay and your frequency shift and stuff like that. So you see you got your virtual analog, so I can choose whichever I want by type. And then I can choose the synthesis type. So your VA, your physical modeling, and your sample based. Stuff like that. Pretty straightforward. Got your mixer. You got a channel for each pad. Then you got your library where you can load projects, kits, or individual sounds. A project is going to have your kit plus the patterns for it, where you can just load your kit or you can load individual sounds into your own kit. And then if we go to the top, that's where you got your step sequencer, song, and then your preferences. So I'm gonna just go through a bunch of the sounds, well, not a bunch, but a few different sounds, and then pick out a kit and kind of show you the workflow in terms of sequencing on this thing. So right now I got the 80s studio drums loaded. So you got acoustic, you got analog, you got sample bass, you got a lot of different types of kits in here. So let's say you got those right there. This is a cool little function that's on the little controller that's not actually on the big Spark controller. They got a dedicated tune knob. Now you can do tuning on the big controller, but it's a secondary function. On here, you got a dedicated knob. So if I want that to be tuned, select. Now that pad is in focus. I hit tune, and now you can do that with any type of sound you want. So let's see. So lots of different stuff. Like I said, you got your general or, you know, common type sounds, and you got your experimental stuff. you can see it can just go from nice and clean to crazy really quickly. Of course, you got all your different, let's check out a couple of these, style bass. So this is a Southern type kit. So you can hear that's layered by velocity. Then, of course, you got all the vintage stuff in here. You can see the 12. You can see the different 808, 909, stuff like that. So say I got my 909 or 808. And let's say I want to mess with that. Let's say I want the decay a little bit longer. Really just a really straightforward, hands-on, fun drum machine, man. It's a lot of different sounds in there. Let's check out maybe something acoustic like a jazz. So you can see how you can go from acoustic to crazy to vintage to synth bass to whatever. So let me pick one out and see if we can do a little quick pattern for you. Let's see. Let's try. So let's say I want to put those in a choke group. I can either select it from here, pull it up, and now I can go put it in a choke group. Same here. Put that one in a choke group. So let's see. Now you don't have a count in on here, so you just pretty much start recording whenever you want. I'm going to make this pattern. We're going to go make it 64 steps. So let's see. Push play. I'm gonna turn my metronome on just so I got something to play along to. Let's just start recording it. So I can hear that that one's in my choke group, so I'm gonna go turn that out. So you see how quick it is to just start laying down stuff. And of course, I can go in, let's say, I can go in and do like, let's say I'm gonna do step mode, so. So it looks like that one's actually in my choke group as well. So I will go in. Let's say maybe I don't want that. I don't like that sound. Just erase the pattern just for that sound. So you can see how quick you can just get lost in a groove. It's really, really straightforward, hands-on. Like I said, as someone who was first introduced to making music with a drum machine, not so much a sampler, this really just feels natural and organic, and I didn't even have to open a manual to figure it out. Just started messing around with it, and it really just made a lot of sense. So you also got a lot of global and instrument-based stuff, so I can change the effects on my individual instruments, or globally, I can mess with the filter, slicer, and stuff like that. So let me show you a little bit of that really quick. You can see your slicer, you can see the different resolutions that you got inside of your slicer. So you got stuff like that. Say I want to mess with the effects on this. Press that. So you get the idea, man. This thing is really, really cool. As soon as I installed it and hooked it up, man, I fell in love with it. I like the form factor. I like the build quality. And it's really fun. The pads are pretty responsive, but everything feels sturdy. But again, it just feels like an instrument. You really don't have to mess with the computer too much, which is cool. Even if you want to mess with the computer, it's very powerful. So you can go in, really do a lot of sound design or just straight up groove creation. So there's a few things I would like to see. I would like to see it where you can quickly adjust the volume for any pad without assigning it to these parameters. And I would like to see it do something like select and then hold the pad and turn the volume knob. I think that would be a cool way to adjust the levels. I wish there was a tap tempo, but there's not. I wish there was a shuffle knob, but there's not. I don't expect them to change the hardware because you do get that stuff on the bigger one. There's no count in. I do wish you could do something like that. But overall, man, I'm really impressed with this. Like I said, if they continue to keep developing the software, this thing is a really, really cool instrument already. So anything they do to it to add to it is going to be a bonus, in my opinion. I give it a 4.5 out of 5 subs, man. Definitely check this out if you want a little bit of something different, just a really tactile drum machine type stuff. Whether you're looking to design drums or build grooves, there's some nice instruments in there already, or you want to build your own, bring your own in, start manipulating them, all that stuff, anything. It's really, really cool. So 4.5 out of 5 subs. This is Arturia SparkLE. It's $2.99. Really, really good price. I've seen it elsewhere for like $2.49, different places. So it's a really, really good bargain. So this is St. Joe, soundsandgear.com. Checking out Arturia SparkLE. Let me know what you think. Rate, comment, subscribe. If you got any questions, let me know. I'll be sure to answer them. I'll see y'all later. Peace.